Good morning, students. Today we shall read the second lesson of geography, the physical feature of India. We have already discussed about Himalayan mountains, the northern plains, the peninsular plateau, and the coastal plain. The last section is the island and the Indian desert. Today we will discuss about the groups of islands. See, the island, besides the vast mainland, the country has two groups of islands. Two groups of islands we have. First is Lakshadweep, the group of islands lying close to the Malabar coast of Kerala. Now we know that the Malabar coast is here. The Malabar coast is here. Opposite to this coast, we have Lakshadweep Island. Lakshadweep Island we have. Here Lakshadweep Island, opposite to the western coast. Western coast. We have Lakshadweep Island. Now, earlier it is composed of a small coral island. Means it is a small coral island, made of coral. You know that what is coral. If you go and search, you will get what is coral. Coral is a kind of substance which is found in the sea. Coral origin, we can say. Coral origin island. Earlier they were known as Lakshadweep. Now, before naming it as Lakshadweep, it was known as Lakshadweep, Miniconi, and Anindweep. It was renamed in 1973. Means these three names was removed, but Lakshadweep, Miniconi, and Anindweep was removed in 1793 and it was renamed as Lakshadweep. It covers a small distance, means what the area covered by the Lakshadweep. It covers a small area of 32 square kilometers. Now, what is the administrative headquarter? The administrative headquarter of this island is Kavarathi. It is all the administration work is carried out from the Kavarathi. You can say it is capital also. Now, the next group of island is the Andaman and Nicobar Island. The Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now, it is elevated chain of island in Bay of Bengal. Now, between Bay of Bengal, between eastern coast, you can say, between eastern coast and Bay of Bengal, we have one more island. This is elongated island, you can say. Elongated means it is a scattered one. So it is called Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now this Andaman and Nicobar Island is divided into two parts. First is called the Andaman in the north. This in the north side it will be named as Andaman. And in south it is known as Nicobar. These two names have been derived for this island. This is called Andaman. Andaman in the north and in the south it is known as Nicobar. It is believed that this island is an elevated portion of submarine mountains. Means we can say this island has originated from submarine mountains. Means suppose there was a mountain inside the sea. The top part got flattened and it was elevated and known as Andaman Nicobar Island. Now what is, since this part is located near to the equator. Means we know that India is divided into two parts. I have already told you it is in tropical zone also and subtropical also. So, after Tropic of Cancer, it is in tropical zone. See, Andaman and Nicobar Island is located near to the equator, having equatorial type of climate and they have dense forest or thick forest, we can say. Now, the next part is the Indian Desert. The Indian Desert. South of the Indian Desert lies toward the western margin of Aravalli Sea. Suppose here we have Aravalli Sea we have here. Aravalli Hills. And this the western margin. Means in the western margin. We can say western margin we have a group of kind of desert which is very unbuilding. That's called the Indian Desert. Unbuilding sandy desert plain. Means this is not built by anyone. It's built unbuilding is here. Very less population can be found there. It's because of unavailability of vegetation and water. The population is very thin. We can say the population is very thin. So sandy plains covered with the sand dunes. Sand dunes means here the mountains of sand. We can say mountains of sand. The Jaisalmer and all, we can say they are a tourist place in Jaisalmer. Some of the places we have Jaipur. These are all some of the tourist places found in these region. But what is the striking feature of that place? Sand dunes and bridges. Bridges, I will make you understand. Suppose there is a sunset bridges. It will be shaped like this. Bridges will be formed, which is quite beautiful side of this region. Region has very low rainfall. The amount of rainfall received by the region is very less. So less amount of rainfall is found here. A streams appear in rainy season. During the rainy season, a small stream, we can say, is formed. But this stream never reaches the sea. Means they have very less water content in them, so they cannot reach the sea. In middle of the way, they get lost. Now, Luni is the only river. This is what the only river of Pakistan is, Luni River. Luni River is the only large river in this region. It has an arid climate. Arid climate is very dry climate it has, with low vegetation cover like cactus, and some of the plants like date palms and all are found here. One of the main features is that today the desert of Rajasthan has been made navigable through Indira Gandhi Canal. Indira Gandhi Canal has made the possibility of agriculture in the desert area of India. So we can say this was desert can be used for irrigation, but only through the availability of water. Large amount of water is available, then we can get that land convert into agricultural land. So this is the end of season. Today we have just discussed about the islands and the desert, and that was the end of this chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.